Hey guys, I'm Annie T Designs, and today I'm going to be talking about a subject in cosplay and sewing and crafting in general that most people do not even consider a skill within sewing and making costumes and even buying costumes. The skill is taking measurements, or accurate measurements. I've noticed throughout the past few years when I've been learning about how to take accurate measurements that a lot of people don't know how to do that. What I mean by that is when someone asks you to take your bust, waist, and hip measurement, they're measuring the wrong place, they're not doing it quite the right way, or they're adding too much, and just a bunch of reasons why the measurements don't turn out accurate and there's problems later on the costumes being made, commissioned, or otherwise said sold to you. So I'm going to give you guys a bunch of tips on how to make your measuring process nice and accurate. So first things first, if possible, try to have someone help you. In my case, I'm going to be showing you how to do it solo just because, well, my assistant isn't exactly someone who knows how to take accurate measurements. But it's a little easier when you have someone to help you to make sure that you're measuring everything properly. And the second thing is you have to be careful about what you're wearing when you're doing the measurements. For example, wearing a sweater like this one, it might actually impact the measurement in the end because it might add an inch or two to the sizing. Ideally, you'll probably want to wear something very simple and a little on the tighter side. Tank top and jeans, quite nice as long as the jeans are not too loose. Sweatpants and a hoodie, not so much. You're going to add some bulk and your measurements are going to be off. Another thing you need to keep in mind when you're doing your measurements and deciding what to wear before you take them is what will you be wearing under the costume? Now in cosplay, there's all sorts of different shapewear you might use. This could go for all sorts of other clothing as well. But sometimes you might be wearing a corset underneath. You might be wearing a push-up bra or a bra that's very much a fake padded bra, fake breasts, or on the contrary, you might be wearing a chest binder, which would push them in, and all of these will affect your measurements. For example, this is how I look in a standard bra. This is how I look without a bra on. The measurements will, again, be a little different. And finally, here's an example of me wearing a small little corselet, a small type of corset, just meant to do a little cinching at the waist and keep everything in place. As you can see, this one also highly affects my waist measurement and how things would sit here. So my waist is in about almost 2 inches when I wear this, and my chest measurement would be different once again. Just to give you a little visual of why it's important to remember what you're wearing before you take the measurement. Another thing to keep in mind is the shoes you're wearing, as if you're wearing a high heel shoe, your posture could completely change and the measurements might be slightly off. So now that you've concluded what you're going to be wearing underneath your clothing before you take your measurements, it's time to actually discuss the measurements themselves. So first and foremost, the main three measurements will be your bust, waist, and hip. Now, I will only be talking about these three main measurements as most other measurement points are worked off of these ones. So if you get these ones wrong, then suddenly you're getting all the other ones afterwards wrong. And they are usually the main and big three. Plus, if I were to go through all the different measurements you can take, we'd be here for a very long time. Now, I'm going to use a piece of elastic to demonstrate all the different points on me so that you can get an idea and get a better visual. The waist is typically far above where people think it is. Most assume it's about where your jeans rest, like mine here. But it is in fact actually above the hip bone and right below the ribs. Different people will sit in slightly different places. Usually it's around your belly button or a little higher. It's typically the smallest point on your torso right here. Next up is the bust. And the bust is typically the largest point on the chest. This is for both male and female. So in my case, that's right around here. Again, depending on what undergarment you're wearing, this could also change and where it's sitting could change. People's bodies are all very different. So mine's right here. Some people might be higher, some might be a little bit lower. And lastly is the hip measurement. The hip measurement is the largest point at the hip area. Now on me, it's actually kind of hard to see where that is on me as I have a very square body. But when I turn around, you realize it's right about there. That's the measurement you want to take. Another alternative name would probably be the booty measurement, because that's actually what you're measuring. A lot of people seem to think that hips are right here and that the waist is right here. But now we know that's a little bit different. Those are actually completely different measurements, which again, they're usually based off where you're measuring your hip, waist, and bust off of. Completely different ones, and when you measure here instead of here, you're gonna have a few inches difference, and it's gonna completely change how you're drafting or how the person who's making your costume fits everything. Now it's time to talk about actually measuring once you know where you're measuring. So, first and foremost, you're gonna wanna use a measuring tape just like this one. You will not wanna use a carpenter's measuring tape and not just roll a ruler around your body. The measurements will get a little bit messed up that way and won't be as accurate as they could be. So what you're going to do is follow along where basically where I have my marks here, and you're going to find the point like so. You want the measurement to be parallel to the ground, or sometimes at the waist you want to tip down a little bit, but typically right around where my little waist tape is. Now what not to do, and this is a very common misconception, is to put your hand completely in there. No, this will completely change the measurements again. That just added about 2 to 3 inches to my total measurement, meaning my pattern would be completely off once I drafted it. When you are measuring, you just kind of want to put a little bit of a finger in there, just like this. So that way there, it adds a little bit of ease, but it doesn't completely change your measurements. Bodies fluctuate a lot, especially the waist area. So if it's half an inch off, it's not a big deal, because one day you're going to be the half an inch bigger, one day you're going to be an inch smaller. It depends on what's going on for your body at that time. Bust and the hip work very much the same way. You want your measuring tape to be parallel to the ground as much as possible, and measuring the points I mentioned before. Measuring tapes, after some time, or sometimes are bought and they're a little bit stretched, they are flexible, they are tapes. They can be easily pulled after time. If you pull too tight when you're doing your measurements, after a while it's going to get pulled and your measurements are going to be off. What you'll want to do is you'll want to compare your measuring tape to a solid ruler. Most people have a ruler lying around, maybe it's from school or wherever, and you want to lay it down and compare it to your measuring tape. If they line up, that's a great measuring tape to use. If not, I would recommend getting a new one, because again, your measurements are going to be completely off now. Every costume, you might have to do a whole new set of measurements over again because of the different shapewear you're wearing underneath. And for younger cosplayers, I would highly recommend every time you make a new costume, always re-measure, even if you're wearing the same undergarments underneath, because especially teenagers, your bodies change so fast, your measurements are going to change fast. And this honestly goes for everyone. I would re-measure often as possible, because measurements change. They get smaller, they get bigger, things are just, the proportions all change. It's constantly changing, and that's just how bodies work. So if you want your measurements to always be accurate, re-measure as much as needed. So thank you guys so much for watching my quick little tips video on how to do basic measurements. I hope this could be very helpful for some of you who are trying to figure out how to do all these different measurements you're seeing in all these different charts you see when you're buying cosplay or looking at a commercial pattern. So thank you for watching, and I hope to see you in my next video. And be sure to like, subscribe, and all that good stuff. And check out my other social media, because I always have different content going on.